Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to download and install the Cursor AI code editor. So let's get started. So first thing, just Google Cursor AI. You'll be getting the first link from cursor.com. Just click that and you'll be having the download for free option. Click it and the download will be getting started. It is about 120 MB in size, so just be patient till then. Yeah, so once the download is complete, open it and the setup will install and you'll be getting an interface to read the basic setup for Cursor, and I'm fine with the default one. I'll just click on continue, and we can also import the VS Code extensions because Cursor AI is just built upon Visual Studio Code, so they both have a similar interface and structure. So you can just use the extensions from VS Code or you can just start from scratch. I will just go with start from scratch. And this is a data preferences. If you want to go with privacy mode, it's up to you. I will go with that. You can just read it through. Click on continue. And here you need to just sign up. Okay. So you can just sign in with your Google account. That's going to take like hardly a minute. Yeah, after signing in, you will be getting an interface like this. This is quite similar to Visual Studio Code, and you'll be getting an empty folder like this. This is the default folder that you get. You can even open your folder like the exact same way that you open a code project in Visual Studio Code. You can just open the file or folder here also. So now to get that AI chat space, what you can do is Control and L. So you just press this, you'll be getting an chat interface to the right, and this is the model. You can change any model that you want. I'll just go with Claude 3.5. So I'll just go with a prompt. Give me a single file with HTML and CSS code for login. That's it. I'm just going to hit enter. So it'll basically give me a HTML code with the CSS styles over here. Yeah, and also gives us an explanation to the same. So now to apply this, you can just click on apply and it says no file to apply. So I'll just go here and create new.html, something like this. Yeah, so now I have a file, and I just click on cancel. And now if I click on apply, yeah, it says did not print the original file, apply to new.html. So I'll just click on continue. So all this code will be applied to my new.html over here. So this is fine. We can just click on accept. That's it. It will go off. So it has a highlight thing, which is super cool. And just save it. And let's see how this appears. So I'll just go here and reveal in file explorer. This is the file. If I just open it, I'll go with Firefox, maybe open. And this is a login screen that I've got. So it looks super nice and super cool. And in case if you want to make changes to this particular login screen, okay, so it has already given us a code, and if you want to change more stuff, so we can just close this. So for this we need to press the key Control and K shortcut. Control and L will open us this right side chat. We can ask anything over here and apply it, but Control and K does the job for us for editing an existing code base. So you need to just select the code which you want to edit. So for this I just want to change the entire code, so I'll just go with Control A first. Select the code and then press Control and K. So this basically has selected the entire code, and I'll just go with the prompt. I want the background to be more colorful with gradient. Just click on submit. So it will live edit the existing code. So here you can see it has added gradient everywhere. That's absolutely fine. I'll just click on accept. So once you're done accepting, it will just blend with the existing code. We can save it. And if you want to redo, so you can redo it by Control and Z. So you can just redo the changes that you made. That's absolutely fine. I'll just accept it. And I'll just go to the same thing. And this is dark pink over here. This is light pink over here. So you can just specify the color if you want, but this pretty much does the job for us. So that's pretty much it. So two shortcut keys, Control L for the chat. You can type anything over here and add it. So that's another chat. And if you want to edit the existing code already there, you need to select the code and press Control K. So this basically edits the existing code. So this is like a high level tutorial, guys, and I hope you have found this useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools, OpenAI, Gemini AI, API, and other programming videos also. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.